It is Wednesday for today's KSAT Q&A. As always, we are joined by Mayor Ron Nirenberg this evening to talk about some of the biggest issues facing our city right now. Let's start with COVID-19, Mayor. We have seen the numbers heading in the right direction. We see that we are in the safe zone this week. Are you feeling any relief right now? Are we at that point?
I wouldn't say relief. In fact, I think we're a ways away from relief. Relief will come when I think that there is a clear path to eradicating this disease, and that really comes from a vaccine. But I do feel that, you know, all the work that we've been doing over the last several months, the very deadly July and August that we saw, has shaken up this community to a point where people are taking this very seriously. We do know that the virus is still out there. The transmission positivity rate is 6.5%. That's not where we need it to be for schools to safely reopen at 100% occupancy. So there's still work to do. Clearly, we have come down from the worst of it in August, but we also don't want to see it spike back up again. So relief or happiness from these numbers is not what I would describe. I would say that I'm pleased that we're back in control, and I want us to stay that way.
Did you have fear, though, that Labor Day would be, another rise in the cases? I mean, from that perspective, you know, are you satisfied with what you've seen?
Yeah, I mean, we certainly brace ourselves every time there's a new stage of reopening or there's a major event where we know there's going to be congregation. So we are in that zone right now where we're watching the numbers very closely from the Labor Day weekend and the reopening at low levels of occupancy of schools. We've got to watch those numbers for the next 5 days or so to know that we really, you know, we absorb the impact of that. We have seen a little bit of a bump, but it clearly has been manageable. And again, we want to keep it that way.
Let's talk about a big issue that we discussed with you last week when you were here, your call for a review on SAPD's body cam policies. We have since then seen another person be shot and killed at the hands of officers. Where are we in that review, and how are you taking in this information that we've seen another deadly incident involving police here?
You know, it's tragic, and it again illustrates the fact that we have another epidemic here in Bexar County that we've talked about for a number of years. In addition to the pandemic that we're experiencing, the epidemic of domestic violence and the involvement of guns in those situations. You know, I've noted many times over the last 6-7 years that virtually every call that we hear about in a dangerous situation is a call for domestic family violence. And this is another one of those cases. In fact, all of the last 3 cases that have gotten attention have been domestic violence calls. They are serious, and when there's a gun involved, they become even more serious. Clearly, this is another tragic event that deserves close scrutiny. It is under investigation. It will be for some time. But, you know, again, I think it illustrates how severe and how complex our challenges as a community with regard to violence of any kind, but in particular intimate partner violence.
We talked to an attorney from the Texas Freedom of Information Foundation on Monday during the segment. He talked about the fact that the city of Dallas has committed to a 72-hour rule unless there's extenuating circumstances, where 72 hours after an incident they will release body cam footage. Is that the kind of timeline that you're looking? Are you talking to the police chief as it goes through this as well? Is that the kind of timeline that you're looking so people know when to expect some of this?
I prefer disclosure, early disclosure of that kind of information, because look, there are cameras everywhere, and usually what we see first are cell phone videos of incidents. Body cam footage is a form of evidence. It is a very, very much part of our system of accountability, and I think the public needs to be part of that. That said, we do need a policy, and that's what I've asked for the city attorney, the police department, our city management, and the council to review together. That information is being collected. We need a policy to govern when that is and under what circumstances that footage is released, so the public has clear expectations, as do we. But we can also respect the investigation process. When there's a criminal investigation, for instance, that is referred over to the district attorney. We want to make sure that we don't compromise an investigation that could lead to, that should lead to justice.
I want to just say one more thing about body cam footage. I know people that the minute you say we want to see the body cam footage, they think there's some anti-police, you know, agenda behind it. That's not what we're talking about here. We're hoping that to people at home can make up their mind about what they see.
Yeah, absolutely. This is about accountability. This is about a disclosure, transparency, making sure that we have the adequate information so that everyone can, you know, interpret the facts the same way, or that we have the same facts to work with. Otherwise, there's hearsay and there's, you know, there's disruption and discord, and that's what we're trying to ease. And body cams were put in place for that reason.
Let's talk a little bit about another big initiative coming the way of voters here in just 40 days or so. In terms of tax initiatives here in town, you have spent a lot of time preparing this plan in order to shift money that was used to go to fund the Edwards Aquifer Protection to now workforce development and then later transportation. We are seeing people come out in opposition of that. We heard from a very familiar face earlier in this show, your former mayoral rival in opposition of that. Why are you still backing this? Why do you think that money does need to be moved to workforce development and then down the road, transportation?
So, number one, to be clear, the Edwards Aquifer Protection Program will continue. The City Council already voted to approve its new funding mechanism that will begin through our normal operations. This is not a new tax. This is not an increase in tax. What this is a recognition that we have 150,000 of our neighbors, families, who are struggling to put food on the table as a result of this pandemic. We are in a bona fide emergency. And the workforce initiative is to help people get back to work and jobs that are available right now that require credentials that they will be able to obtain through this job training program. This is about ensuring that the place that we call home, where so many of our families are struggling as a result of job loss and income loss from this pandemic, are able to get back to work, get back on their feet. There's not a more important cause right now than for us to rally around our neighbors in need.
Mayor Ron Nirenberg, as always, appreciate your time on a Wednesday. We'll see you on the Night Beat tonight.
Sounds good. Thanks, y'all.
We'll be right back.